Hello everyone, it's Naoki here. Today, I'm going to show you how to draw a vector character with a pen tool in Adobe Illustrator. Let's get started. Pen tool is a core function of the Illustrator. You can make and draw any object you like. In this case, you no longer spend hours finding or buying images online. You can simply make it on your own. In this lesson, create an outlined vector character by practicing the pen tool and filling the color. First, let me introduce the name of the elements and the essential function of them. I will make an ellipse shape for a sample here and click it with a direct selection tool. You can see the white dots around the object. It's called anchor point. And if you clicked each of the anchor point, you can see the extra line. It's called handle. The handle represents the attribute of the each anchor point, such as creating a smooth or sharp curve. All vector images are made of the anchor point and handle. So when you can manipulate them, you can make anything with the vector quality. Okay, let's try the pen tool. This time we will practice it by tracing the sketched image of Nate, which is Naoki Studio's original character. Let's place the sketched image in Illustrator, reduce the opacity to 40%. Then lock the layer and change the name to OG, stand for original. Then create another layer on the top and it's called working. It will be your working layer. Make sure you have no fill and black stroke. The thickness is 4 point. Then we are ready. Let's have a pen tool from the sidebar. Shortcut is P. Let me show you the feature of the pen tool first. If you just clicking like this, you will see the jaggy shapes like that. That is the first mistake a lot of beginners made. If you want to have a smooth line like this, instead of just clicking, click and drag over the direction you want to go next. As soon as you drag it, you can see the handle. It represents the amount of possible line areas. You will see more about handle later. Let's make a cap area first. The point of drawing the line with the pen tool is to look at the direction and the amount line of the handle. The next line will go in the direction where the handle is pointing. So make sure you pay attention to the direction of the handle. When the line of the handle went beyond the shape, it doesn't look good. Let's see what happened. Because the line tried to go way far this way, but I clicked here. That created that weird curving line. Make sure the handle line stays within the shape. Don't go beyond the shape. When you come close to the end of the shape, you will see the circle icon. The meaning is that you are closing the anchor point to complete the shape. Let's finish up the cap area. As you can see, if you click on a different area without closing the anchor point, the line keeps coming with you. In this case, you need to click Enter to finish the line. Then you can make a separate line without closing the anchor point. Usually, both handles move together. But if you want to move only one side of the handle, hold Option. Then change the direction to where you want to go. Let's keep tracing all other lines. Once you finish all tracing, let's remove the unnecessary lines. Let's start with the top cap area. First, click on the line with the direct selection tool to confirm the location of all anchor points. We want to keep the line until just before the top cap object. In that case, you need to add an extra anchor point at the edge of the top cap object with the pen tool. If you come close to the line of the object, you will see the icon besides the pen tool changed to plus icon. Once you have the plus icon, click on the line. Then you can see you have an extra anchor point. Let's do the same thing on the other side. And another anchor point in between. Confirm you have three anchor points on both edges and one in between. Then get direct selection tool, select the center anchor point and delete it. Let's do this again. Get the direct selection tool and click on the line to check the location of the anchor points. With the pen tool, add an extra anchor point on the edge of the deleting point and one anchor point in between. In this case, we already have one here, so we don't have to make another one. Then, with the direct selection tool, select the center anchor point and delete it. Let's clean up the rest of the lines. The outline is almost finished. It's time to clean up them. I will change the stroke to a circle cap within the stroke window. If you don't have a stroke window, go to the top, window, and stroke. Let's take a closer look to check everywhere. And if you found any place you don't like, you can adjust them with a direct selection tool. I just found I forgot to draw the eyes. Let's create eyes and eyebrows. First, make another layer for them. I will use shape tool to make them. Let's start with eyebrows. Get ellipse tool and adjust it on the top line of the eyebrow. Then create another ellipse shape for the bottom line. Select both shapes, go to Pathfinder. If you don't see the Pathfinder, go to the top, window, Pathfinder. Inside Pathfinder, click minus front. Then you can have an eyebrow shape. Do the same thing for the other side. Then create ellipse shapes for the eyes. Then select eyes and eyebrows together. Remove the stroke and fill the color in black. Once you finish the outline, let's move on to filling the color. Lock the eyes and eyebrows layer and create another layer underneath and named color. And come back to the working layer. Select all lines and copy with the command C. Hide the working layer. Paste the line in the exactly the same place with the command F in the color layer. Remove the stroke and have live paint bucket. Shortcut is K. Select the color. I've already made the color palette for the character, but you can choose any color you like from the swatches. Then, filling the color by clicking the area. Get the working layer back, and now you can have a vector character of Nate. So this is how to draw a vector character with a pen tool in Adobe Illustrator. It looks complex, but if you spend some time for practice, you're gonna love it. I hope it helps. Thanks for watching. See you next time.